Good afternoon, 47. Your destination is Marrakesh, Morocco, where civil riots are looming. Your targets are private banker Klaus Strandberg and army general Reza Zidane, two of the conspirators in a sinister plot to overthrow Morocco's fragile government. Strandberg, a former bank CEO who stole billions of dollars worth of savings from the Moroccan people, was facing trial for investment fraud. But early this morning, a band of heavily armed mercenaries freed Strandberg from his prison transport, resulting in the death of several police officers. Strandberg now takes refuge at his native Swedish consulate, in front of which crowds of angry protesters have gathered, demanding his handover to Moroccan authorities. We believe General Zidane orchestrated Strandberg's escape to infuriate the public and spark nationwide riots, allowing Zidane to impose martial law. Operating out of a field HQ at a nearby abandoned school, he will no doubt use the riots to depict the Rabat government as weak and inept, and persuade the general's staff to support a fully-fledged military coup in the name of national security. Our client, building contractor Hamilton Lowe, who stands to lose a fortune in government contracts, has hired us to prevent the coup d'etat. To do so, you need to paralyze Zidane's rebel forces and prevent the riots from escalating further, hence the double contract. This is quite the political powder keg, 47, so be careful. The fate of a nation is at stake. I will leave you to prepare. Welcome to Marrakesh, 47. The situation grows more tense by the minute. The consulate is under lockdown, but the protests are only a stone throw away from full-blown riots, and Zidane won't hesitate to unleash his troops. So whatever you're planning, time is of the essence. Good luck, 47.
Very sorry, let me get out of your way.
I am so honored by your visit to my humble stall. Let me show you my fine pots and plates.
Oh, how's your father?
Doing well, thanks for asking. He's upstairs right now working on this novel of his, some kind of political thriller, I think. You know, airport lit.
Oh, that's nice. So he doesn't miss the old school?
Well, he was headmaster for 30 years, and he still carries around the master key. You know, the one that fits all the locks? It's seem to be able to park the damn thing. But that's nostalgia for you.
Well, maybe now he'll be...
The old headmaster of the school Zaydan is using as his field HQ lives right above the carpet shop. According to his son, he kept the school's master key out of nostalgia. Supposedly, this opens any lock in the building.
Now he'll be a famous writer instead.
Right. And maybe my carpets are magical. Hey, stop!
So much for breaking and entering. You're in. Good work, 47. Now to locate General Zaydan. That is General Reza Zaydan, Keeper of the Peace.
You, stop!
Seriously, though, you believe for a second that Zayden is masterminding this move by himself? He doesn't have the smart. Strike the narcotic, man. Charm the nigger off most women.
Hey, you there.
Okay, yeah, you. Fishy fella. Who are you?
Strike the fear of God into men and charm the knickers off most women. But you and I both know Reza Zayden is no mastermind.
I hear you, brother. Down from the...
Honey.
No, Wanda.
Listen, that was one time. I was never even there. You keep saying that. No, I hear what you're saying, and I completely agree.
No,
Target down. Move on to Klaus Strand.
Man, state your business here. What's up?
Attention. This is First Lieutenant Leviard.
Huh?
We are on full
report.
Thank you.
classroom now. It's clear. Moving on. Over.
This is a waste of time.
Stand down. Understood.
Command, I have arrived at the location and it looks clear. Over.
Show your pretty mug. We'll find you eventually. Don't bother wasting our time, pal.
Watch out! Our guy can still be around. Back to work, everybody.
Nailed
it. No bones. Snailson.